This is probably something that's more likely to happen to you at some point in your gun owning life. We're the Arms Attorneys. Today we're going to talk about negligent discharge. We'll be answering questions like, what are the criminal consequences? What's your potential civil liability? And what can it mean for your possible future living situations? But before we get started, show your support for the Second Amendment by hitting the like button.
And to kick things off, let's start with that first question. You know, what are the criminal consequences when it comes to negligent discharge? And there's a lot of different things at play here, but most importantly is the mental state when it comes to negligent discharges. You know, for every crime, there's two parts. There's the mental state, and then there's the actual physical act itself. And when we look at negligent discharges, what we see is most of the time, and in most states, this is not going to be criminal. Some states do have some, you know, reckless, below reckless standard, like negligence, criminal negligence. But what we see is because there's no intent to cause harm, there's no conscious disregard of, you know, maybe some, you know something's going to happen if you pull the trigger. Because we don't have that mental state, a lot of times it's not a crime.
Yeah, I would say more states than not choose not to criminalize negligent discharge, absent any other, you know, aggravating circumstance, of course, just pure negligent discharge, because, you know, for the most part, accidents aren't a crime, right? That's the idea. However, that doesn't mean that accidents won't get you in trouble legally, which brings us to the second issue here, which is your potential civil liability. And, you know, this, I mean, I think we can really flip the criminal issue on its head when we talk about civil liability and say, you're pretty much going to be liable for like every dollar that is cost by your negligent discharge, right?
And that's where we get tort law.
So, I mean, think about things like you have a negligent discharge, the bullet leaves the window of your house, hits somebody's vehicle. Well, you are going to be liable for the damages to that vehicle. Maybe hits a person and you're going to have to be liable for their personal injury, for their hospital bills, things like that. I mean, really, the cutoff is, I mean, it's pretty attenuated for what you're not going to be liable for. So, like, but for example, let's say that your bullet hits, you know, goes through your wall of your apartment, hits your neighbor. Your neighbor's wife had a job interview that morning. She can't go because she's taking her husband to the emergency room and dealing with that. Well, you're not going to be liable for her lost future wages because she missed that job interview, right? But, I mean, everything, all the property damage you caused and all the damage you caused to his person, almost certainly.
And it all comes down to causation. What did you cause? But that kind of brings us to another question that comes up frequently, which is, you know, how does, and we talked to a lot of folks who this affects, how does this affect my living situation, especially when it comes to apartments? Now, the apartment law is going to be different all over the United States. Most states allow, you know, to for a person to keep and store firearms inside of their, you know, dwelling, their habitation, including their apartment. Some states may have some restrictions, but, you know, in states where it's legal, what we see happen a lot of times, if there is a negligent discharge in an apartment, there's a lot more to it than maybe just even damages.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we see over and over again, you have that negligent discharge in your apartment complex. Maybe it enters the neighbor's property, maybe it doesn't, but somehow the apartment complex gets alerted to the fact that you had a negligent discharge. Unfortunately, it is baked in, especially these big corporate complexes, it is baked into virtually every lease in virtually every state and every apartment complex throughout the entire country that you cannot discharge firearms within your unit. And so what we see is, even though it was an accident, even if nobody's hurt, even if there's, you know, really no big deal at all, you are probably going to be evicted. And that's just one of those things. It is contrary to every lease I've ever examined. And so, unfortunately, at that point, you're just stuck looking at, okay, what does my state's property code say about how long they have to give me? You know, do they have to give me 30 days? Do they have to give me 60 days notice? How long until I have to move out? But ultimately, they are going to kick you out and, you know, you probably do have to go.
And the final question that we get all the time is, do I need to report a negligent discharge to the police? And this is a really dicey one, and that's why the only way to answer that is you have to speak to an attorney licensed in your state. It's, you know, important as a law-abiding gun owner that you have, you know, you have an attorney contact, or at least you have an idea of, all right, who am I going to call if something happens? And this is where they can really, you know, save your bacon. Because I've spoken to clients who, you know, let's say they discharge into the floor of their own house. You know, here in the state of Texas, there's no duty to report, and nobody's hurt. And so I'm not going to tell that person to tattle on themselves. You know, it's a little bit different, or where things become more complicated is when it leaves your property. That's when things get a little bit more dicey and it gets even worse. You know, obviously, if somebody's injured, you want to call 911. You want to get the medical attention right away. But whenever the bullet leaves your property, it's really important that you speak to an attorney, because only they would be able to advise you, hey, you got to tell the police about this. You don't have to tell the police about this. So, you know, that's what you got
to
do.
Yeah, not to mention, I think there are states that actually require you to report your own negligent discharge.
Yep.
Constitutional violation, though that may be, in my opinion.
Right.
There are some states that have those sorts of laws on the books. So if you get into the situation, or maybe even before, do a little research, I think, on the front end.
Yep.
I mean, they say there are two types of people, right? The ones who have had negligent discharges and the ones who haven't yet.
Right.
So it is something, you know, we prepare a lot for self-defense, but this is probably something it's more likely to happen to you at some point in your gun owning life. So
yeah, than a self-defense incident. So, you know, practice those good standards of ensuring the firearm's unloaded. Don't keep ammunition in the same place that you clean your firearm. Treat every firearm like it's loaded, and you have to ensure it's unloaded. You know, these things can be very dangerous. But we hope you enjoyed this discussion. If you did, consider subscribing, hitting the like button, and help us fight that anti-2A algorithm by sharing this video.
And please continue to question and comment below. Until next time, we're the Armed Attorneys.